But first, Jim Carlson, the owner of The Last Place on Earth, has been found guilty.
Live from the WDIO broadcast studios, this is Eyewitness News at 10 on WDIO WIRT.
Today is the culmination of over 2 years of this community combating the open sales of synthetic drugs in our downtown.
Duluth Mayor Don Ness reacting after Last Place on Earth owner Jim Carlson was found guilty of more than 50 charges today. Good evening, I'm Darren Danielson. The controversial Carlson is behind bars tonight after a jury found him guilty on 51 of the charges that he faced. Reporter Alan Hoagland was in the courtroom for us today.
Jim Carlson was found guilty of 51 of the 55 counts against him. The jury deliberated for 12 hours or less, this even after the judge called the case overly complicated and confusing. We've been watching him walk in and out of this Minneapolis courthouse for more than 3 weeks. But today, Jim Carlson is in custody.
On behalf of both Lava and the love of her life, Jim, that we're very sorry about the verdict.
John Markham is the attorney for Carlson's girlfriend, Lava Haugen. In all, Carlson, Haugen, and Carlson's son, Joseph Gellerman, faced 55 counts, accused of selling illegal synthetic drugs from The Last Place on Earth. The jury found Carlson guilty of 51 counts, including distribution of a controlled substance and causing misbranded drugs to be introduced into interstate commerce. When asked if he lost the case before it began, Carlson's attorney, Randall Teig, said this.
We were severely handicapped before it began.
And in response to the verdict?
In a sense, it wasn't surprising because Mr. Carlson was forced to go to trial with a hand tied behind his back.
Teig says that handicap was his inability to use statements from a DEA spokesperson and Senator Amy Klobuchar's office. According to Teig, Klobuchar's office issued a press release saying everything Carlson was doing was legal. And if the evidence would have been allowed?
I think the verdict, no question, would have been different.
While Carlson is in custody, his girlfriend and son are not. A jury found Haugen guilty of 4 counts and Gellerman 2 counts. The judge says sentencing will come within the next couple of weeks. Meanwhile, the defense will be laying out their argument as to why they deserve a new trial. We're in Minneapolis. I'm Alan Hoagland for Eyewitness News.
And Duluth City leaders holding a news conference this afternoon, just hours after the verdict was reached.
Duluth was on the front lines of what has clearly become a national problem. And this was, in many ways, testing grounds for the strength of the nation's laws as it relates to synthetic drugs.
Well, one of the things to remember is this impacted a lot of families and a lot of people, and that lives are forever altered because of these drugs.
The prosecution in the Carlson case said that they couldn't issue a comment because of the federal government shutdown, which is now in its 7th day, and with no real end in sight. Meanwhile, 2 ordinances passing tonight in Virginia getting tough on synthetic drugs. According to Councilor Charlie Baraboo, the city council passed a broad ban on the sale, possession, or manufacture of the substances tonight. That passed alongside a public nuisance ordinance relating to synthetics as well. The city of Virginia has 2 shops that sell the drugs. Baraboo says the ordinances should go into effect 2 weeks from today. Meanwhile, Baraboo says he's also very pleased with how the Last Place on Earth trial turned out. The guilty verdict yesterday in Minneapolis federal court giving Virginia's new ordinances stronger precedent. And he's not alone in that feeling. Just about everyone we talked to downtown is pleased.
I think it's great news. I think he deserves what he's getting, and he was selling illegal substances, so I think it's great. Before, we probably wouldn't have been on the side of the street. We would have just stayed across the street and did our little running over there.
The controversial Last Place on Earth store has been closed since July. A district court judge has said he'd rule on the city's request to close it for a year after this federal case wrapped up, which did yesterday. The store's closure has meant a boost in business for Tycoon's Bar and Restaurant, which is just down the block.
We're glad that it's over. We're glad that there's been resolution brought to it, and we're happy that there's a model now to shut down other places that are selling similar chemicals.
Jim Carlson was convicted on 51 of the 55 federal charges he faced. His girlfriend convicted of 4, his son 2. Sentencing will likely take place for them within 60 days. But Carlson and his son still face 12 state criminal charges. St. Louis County Attorney Mark Rubin said they are awaiting the setting of the trial date for that. Another Northland state legislator, leading brainstorming sessions today on how to battle synthetic drugs. A joint hearing today strategizing solutions for what's quickly becoming a statewide problem. We know all about it here in Duluth with the last place on earth issues, which is why DFL Duluth representative Eric Simonson is heading the synthetic committee. Aside from regulation of the substances, Simonson says they're also looking into more preventative and educational approaches.
Yeah, I think early on our committee had determined that, you know, just trying to legislate the problem away through criminal statutes is probably not the only solution. And we want to just really provide some good education out there because, by and large, we're finding that so many people really don't understand that synthetic drugs are really dangerous and hazardous, and people need a good resource for information.
Simonson told us they're looking to create an informational website as well and at establishing broader drug education classes in our schools.